My name is Nancy Miller. I'm a correspondent with the Akron-Beacon Journal, and I just wanted to get your name and title. I know you said Jody German, but I don't know how you spell it.
First name is with an I, and you think you have the last name? It's G-E-R-M-A-N.
Just like people.
Yep. Okay.
And what's your title there?
Legal Division Administrator.
And how long do you think it's going to take to get e-filing live? I know you said a process of several years, but...
To go live?
Yeah.
On our first case type?
Okay.
9 months, and that could be optimistic.
Okay.
Because we still have to negotiate the contract and get all those specifications nailed down. So, you know, I really want to say a year, but I'm hoping that it will be less than that.
And how long do you think it would take to get the entire system implemented in the county courts?
I would hazard a guess that within 2 years we should have the Court of Common Pleas, including the General Division and Family Court, online, and then hopefully probate shortly thereafter. I think within 2 years. That may be optimistic, but we'd rather be optimistic.
But we want to be optimistic. Correct.
You know, just one sentence. You know, 9 months to get the first case type started, potentially, but at least 2 years to get it in implemented in full.
Yeah.
Oh,
mm-hmm.
Yeah. Fairly.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
That's all.
Great. Thanks for your interest.
Okay. Have you gotten any attorney input and as to how the system's going to be put together, local attorneys?
That will be part of the process. We'll involve the prosecutor's office, the public defender, the sheriff's department, the local bar association, but those will be some steps that will come down the line a little bit.
Okay.
And we've had some of the attorneys on the committee involved in the beginning when we started to put this whole idea together as well.
Do you have a sense of the receptivity of the local bar to going to this system?
Well, I think most of them will be very happy and satisfied with it. Those that have used the other systems are going to be, you know, really looking forward to using our system, but there will be some out there that probably won't be too excited about the idea.
Well, a lot of attorneys have had some experience with the federal system,
sure. So
expectations would be somewhat similar.
Yes.
And we did go down to Franklin County. They've implemented e-filing. We met with them and asked the direct question, has it made a reduction in paperwork? And they said, yes, it has. It's reduced the amount of paperwork. And over time, it through attrition, it will probably require less people to handle the amount of paperwork that we currently handle.
Ms. German indicated in her comments during the session that it's going to be a seamless process and the scanning. Does that also benefit the documents getting online so people can access them quicker through CGIS?
Absolutely. I mean, it'll be a 1 minute process, and now it could be a couple day process.
Do you have a total cost figure so far? How much has been spent to the point where you are?
I don't think we've... Oh, the only thing we spent was the contract with the National Center.
Correct. Which was, 5,000 maybe?
Yeah, it was between $5,000 and $6,000. We contracted with the National Center for State Courts to assist with the RFP.
Mm-hmm.
So when that was all being written, they reviewed it and gave their input about the request for proposal before it went out.
Of course, the big item is going to be determined in terms of the negotiated contract.
Correct.
To implement the system. I know that is not known specifically, but do you have a ballpark figure that...
That's what, as we mentioned in there, it's $1,110,000 and change, but 1.1.
Okay, will be the final cost. And of course, there's going to be ongoing maintenance costs beyond that, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And is this money going to be recovered over time through the payments by users of the system?
this will be a pay-as-we-go process. In other words, we'll have the money in place to pay for this, and it will be done on the basis of milestones. In other words, we're not laying out all this money up front. We'll pay for the system as it's implemented. But the money is being collected, and it's been in the process of being collected since 2011.
Okay. From users?
Yes, it's all filing fees.
Oh, okay. So that you have a reserve of money to work with? Understand that correctly?
That's correct.
And what are the reserve dollars right now?
In excess of $500,000. I'm going to, and Martin, don't hold me to this exactly, but I think the last time I looked, we had probably, there's probably $525,000 in the fund currently.
I see.
And then there will also be a contribution made by the family court to this, because they're going to be covered by e-filing as well, and they will be making annual contributions to the cost of this also.
And then the last piece, the municipal court, when do you project that will happen?
That is totally up to them. That's their decision. We brought them in when we started to talk about this, and they weren't quite ready to go with getting on board with what we wanted to do. So it's totally up to them.
Is there a sponsor judge on the municipal court side? I know that you talked about Judge Heath being the person to stand forward in the common pleas. Is there a similar person from the municipal court standpoint?
I don't believe. We've talked to the clerks and representatives from the various municipal court clerk's office, Alliance and Masson and Canton. Thank you. It's like I know there's a third. We have not, as far as we know, there's not a judge involved in any of that conversation, just the clerks.
Okay, well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
My only one question is, does e-filing mean that there's no more paper filing? There's only one way to do it once you go to e-file.
Yeah, it will eventually become mandatory. It's not going to start out that way, but eventually everything will be mandatorily filed.
Okay. And we'll probably start with one case type, like foreclosure cases. That's what they started with down in Franklin County. They started with foreclosure cases. That's one part of the civil docket. Get this moving, get it implemented, get the bugs worked out, and then expand to the full civil docket, then the criminal, and on down the line. But we'll start with one case type.
And when the system becomes available, it'll be first come, first served. Whoever happens to be the first attorney to use the system, is there going to be a pilot?
It'll be a pilot.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. We'll do a lot of filing parallel to each other to make sure everything is operating the way it's supposed to.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.